At the MRC Weatherall Institute of Molecular Medicine, our goal is to understand the molecular processes that underpin human health and disease. This knowledge is the foundation upon which we build new strategies to diagnose, treat, and prevent a wide range of medical conditions.
When David Weatherall first founded this institute, the reason he chose this site was to locate the Institute for Molecular Medicine within the body of the hospital. And it really attracts a really good mix of scientists and clinician scientists, and working together, I think we all have a really clear focus on discovery of new mechanisms that can be translated to strategies to improve human health.
The problem that I noticed with ovarian cancer is, after what we regard as clinicians, highly successful treatment, a lot of our patients come back with recurrence. And that's because no matter how successful treatment is, you're almost always left with very little number of cancer cells, which we call minimal residual disease. With Singular Bio, what we do is, once you've identified a number of mutations, we use those to literally get out the immune cells from the patient's own tumor or blood that can see and react to those mutations. And by then expanding those cells outside the body, we are able to generate millions of immune cells that could then go back into the same patient and fight the tumor.
The focus of my research group is really inspired by the needs of patients I look after in the clinic. So these patients generally have a type of chronic blood cancer called a myeloproliferative neoplasm. Most of the therapies that we currently have are largely symptomatic in the things that they can improve. So they improve patients' symptoms, make them feel better, but they do very little in terms of changing the natural history of the cancer. With alethiomics, we use advanced genetic techniques to really look at the gene changes that are occurring specifically in the cancer cells. And we can use this technique to discriminate very carefully between the cancer cell and the wild-type counterpart, enabling us to target the cancer cells. We've also developed a suite of advanced models to enable us then to test those therapies in the relevant tissue setting. We believe that bringing these techniques together will enable us to not only identify new therapies, but then more robustly test them and hopefully accelerate and improve the chances of them being successful when we move towards clinical trials.
So Immunocore is the leader in a completely new class of therapeutics based on T-cell receptors, which have very wide potential. Immunocore's therapies work in some cancers where really there are no other treatments at all. It's a way of specifically targeting solid tumors and activating the immune system against those tumors. Immunocore has been involved in changing the world's view on immunotherapy for cancer. Immune-based therapies are the future for oncology. Probably the only class of therapies that hold the hope of generating complete responses that will control cancers in the long term.
So the WIMM is a really outstanding scientific environment. It houses a number of world-class core facilities. Together, these create a really terrific environment that enables us to work at the bridge between fundamental discovery and clinical translation.
The WIMM definitely provided the background for setting up Immunocore. Immunology was fantastic there. The knowledge and expertise and the atmosphere was fantastic.
No question in my mind that the environment of the WIMM was so conducive of actually starting such a great endeavor.
The future is bright, with more spin-out companies on the horizon, poised to make a tangible difference to people's lives.